Peace be with you, and thanks for joining us today. It's a privilege and joy to have this opportunity to bring into the sanctuary of your home a reprise of a very special program that was held here, Abbott Music at First Plymouth in January, the Nebraska premiere of the American Spiritual Ensemble. Today you'll hear music that hearkens to the heart of the African-American spiritual tradition, and you'll hear it sung by incredibly expressive and spiritually powerful singers gathered from across the country. It was a special moment for us to remember the history and to acknowledge the spiritual power of these great songs of the African American spiritual tradition. Our broadcast today is sponsored by Union Bank and Trust. We're so thankful for their ongoing support of Abbott Music. And also, we're here today in part to raise funds for the good folks at the Malone Center, a real treasure here in Lincoln. And you'll be learning more about them later in the program. Abbott Music's mission is gathering to experience music that inspires. I'm so grateful that we have this unique and beautiful albeit virtual, opportunity to do it today.
Thank you so much for being here this afternoon. We are the American Spiritual Ensemble, and the mission of the American Spiritual Ensemble is to keep the American Negro spiritual alive. And to that end, we get to travel throughout the world celebrating this great music. The spirituals are the folk songs of the American Negro slaves. They started off as melodies. And there are over 6,000 of these melodies. And then they were fashioned into these great choral pieces in 4, 6, 8 parts. And these songs are about hope, hope of a people that came here against their will and found a way to communicate, found a way to survive, and a lot of it was because of the power of this music. From the spiritual grew many sorts of forms of music. From spirituals grew jazz, blues, gospel, pop music, Broadway. One of the big things that came from spirituals is called call and response. I think you've heard of Diana Ross and the Supremes. Martha Rees and the Vandellas. Yeah, Gladys Knight and the Pips. Yeah, that's all call and response. Well, that started in the slave fields, in the plantations. As the workers were working, all of a sudden, you may hear a sound of a piece like Swing Low, where someone may start in the field singing, and then the other people just join in like this.
Swing low, sweet chariot.
Then the people would sing,
come, you are to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot.
all of a sudden, this one little melody, as we began to hear it, breaks into thousands, not thousands, but many different parts, like this. Imagine being in the plantation home, having dinner, and hearing voices all around the plantation singing these beautiful, beautiful spirituals. Well, that's how they started, and then they grew into what we have today. Of course, this is not just music for one people. This is music, this is American music. And now it's celebrated all over the world. And people all over the world love to hear spirituals and to sing spirituals. And I'm so delighted that spirituals are so celebrated in Lincoln, Nebraska. So thank you, Tom. Thank you to all of you for being so supportive and realizing the importance of spirituals. The next piece is a call and response piece. It's called I Thank You, Jesus. It's a little more intricate in terms of call and response, so you may not be able to follow along, but try. And of course, if we sing anything that you know, please feel free to sing right along.
Thank you. King Jesus brought the light to me, and with every star refused to shine. I know King Thank you.
Let my people come.
changed, 'cause the angels in heaven done signed my name. You know that I know I've been changed. I know I've been changed. I know I've been changed. 'Cause the angels, they signed my name. Well, I prayed all night, and I prayed all day too. The angels signed my name. Well, I'm gonna keep on a praying till I come through. The angels signed my name. I know I've been changed. And the water was cold. The angel signed my name. It chilled my body, but not my soul. The angel signed my name. You know that I know I've been changed.
Among the great traditions of Advent music is the idea of collaboration, coming together. And though it was such a privilege, such a joy to have the American Spiritual Ensemble here to sing for us, it was an incredible gift to have the opportunity to sing with them. The Plymouth Choir and the Quinn Chapel Choir and the University of Nebraska-Lincoln Chamber Singers join now in the world premiere of a piece, an arrangement of the spiritual Rise, Shine by Lincoln's own Dr. Marcus Garrett.
Rise and shine, rise and shine.
We'll hear more now about the Malone Center, who we honor and who we celebrate their mission and their ministry in our city today. And after we hear from their executive director, we'll hear from some of their children in song.
Hello, I'm John Goodwin, the executive director of the Malone. For decades, the Malone has created and facilitated programs to combat the racial disparities and inequities in justice, healthcare, and social systems. In that time, we have served as a cornerstone for educational, cultural, health, and welfare programs to create unity and prosperity in Lincoln while honoring our African American heritage. Our programs emphasize giving youth and families new experiences and opportunities they would not have access to otherwise. We still have a long way ahead of us, and we are dedicated to developing new programs to meet the needs of those we serve. Please consider visiting our website at malonecenter.org to learn more about our community engagement efforts. Thank you.
Thank you.
Friends, thank you again for spending this special time with us today. We hope that you'll find the music that you've heard today to be an inspiration in these lengthening days. And we look forward to the time we can gather again here to make more Abend music. May your days ahead be blessed.